name is Miss Harlow of Posh. If you are a new subscriber, do not forget to give this video a thumbs up if you like it at the end of the video. Do not forget to subscribe below so you can get those YouTube alerts when all my new vlogs and content videos are uploaded. I just want to say hey to my Posh babies. Miss you guys. Today has been a hectic day so far. I've went to the doctor. Home sweet home. Home sweet home. Home sweet home. First thing I do is put my bag down. Put my bag down. Put my bag down. This is that little area. I still don't know what I'm gonna do with that thing. I think I'm gonna definitely hang it up. Put my keys on it. Put the key on it. I'm always looking for my keys, guys. Every time I get home, I'll be looking for my keys. So this is the perfect little station to have them at. So happy to be home, but I only came home for 1 hour. Y'all, I love light, so I literally have all the lights on. But I came home for like 1 hour. Don't look at my background. It's a mess everywhere, whatever. To get some videos up, honey, I'm just about to do the whole weekend really, really quickly. And I'm trying to take my time, make sure I edit as best as I can because I don't need no complaints in those comments. So I actually just was reading my DM on Snap and someone was just sending some motivation about how to deal with the comments and stuff like that. So I'm going to take her advice. First thing I want to do, I come in the house and I get me an ice cream sandwich. Many ice cream sandwiches. Lit, honey. Lit. And I only got a couple more left. But as I was saying, I'm about to go to my desk and get started. I have not finished decorating. I just literally added a chair last night. Got my phone on the charger. Gold and white will be the theme, you know. Got my glow up hello light. Everything need to be hung up, painted, wallpaper put up, whatever. Oh, and I have to spray paint the legs. Them. Yeah. I just love my outfit today. Everybody got a red cup blowing it down. We're trying to have fun and live life like it ain't no tomorrow. And I'm gonna be here till the morning. You gon' be here when I'm calling. Ooh yeah, ooh yeah, ooh yeah, yeah, yeah. Pull up gang too strong. I might hop out too fast. I don't know how I'll last. I do it just to stun on your ex. You know a cool nigga up next. And I'ma leave your bitch obsessed. She wanna fuck with me if she could. Cause she know it's all good. Like the bottom of the net. Wet. I'ma pull up, just behind the stern. Everybody know what's up. Okay guys, I'm still sitting on my computer. I just finished doing my outro. Let's see if I can show you guys what it looks like. That's what it looks like. I'm gonna add a song to it. So this is January outro. I'm trying to get a video up. So I might add a few things to it later, but not right now. I wanted to talk to you guys about something that was on my chest. So, y'all my babies, I feel like I can talk to you guys. So, that's what I'm gonna do. Alright, so, yesterday morning I woke up and I read the comments. I would be a liar to say that my feelings was not hurt, because they were. So, I'm gonna let this be the last time my feelings are hurt about some comments, for sure. Because if this is what I choose to do, if YouTube is going to be a part of my other incomes and jobs listing that I do, then I have to be able to take it. Just like I can take everything else on Instagram and other social media outlets. So, I just want to clear some up. This will be my very last time explaining anything or even defending myself. Because whatever you have to say about me, you're just going to be saying whatever you want to say. Because I'm not going to be the one, my arm's hurt, I'm not going to be the one to go back and forth with anybody that I would never meet, probably. Alright, so let's edit as we're talking. I'm really trying to sit my camera down. You know, let's just hold it. All right, so a couple things that was said in the comments was, I'm just a trophy, he would never marry me, and something like that. So I sent that comment to Block, and he was just like, bae, first of all, you would have been had a ring if I feel like you would accept the ring. I've told him plenty of times that I wasn't ready. I feel like I am becoming ready and starting to be ready, but that's nobody's business. That's our personal in-house business. And when I'm ready, I feel like he's ready and we're ready together as a team, and God is first and all of that stuff, then we'll do it. It's no one's business. And that's just as simple as that. I told y'all, don't mention my man, don't mention my family, and we cool. Say what you want to say about me, because that's what comes with the territory. Another thing. I'm trying to think. DK Pharrell old apartment. I do not live in them young adults' apartment. They did not start building these when they decided to move in high rises. This is not my first high rise. This is not my second high rise. This is not my second condo with floor to ceiling windows and big bedrooms and fancy and that. It's not my first. And I don't want to seem like a brag or materialistic girl y'all try to make me seem, but it seems like I gotta keep repeating myself to remind y'all to give me my fucking credit. Y'all not gonna discredit me, boo. You're not gonna just, because I wasn't vlogging in 2014, 2013, 2015, and barely 2016. Y'all not gonna give me my credit on all the stuff that happened. So this is not their place. If they had a similar one or same floor plan layout, that's their business. I moved from a 2-bedroom to this 1.5-bedroom because I chose to, because I like this floor plan better than the 2-bedroom. They all just about cost the same, honey. There's no coin saving around here. It's all very expensive. So it is what it is. Before I moved in this building, I stayed in I had a townhome that was 4 levels, 5.5 baths, and 4 bedrooms. And the Vinings. You know that area in Atlanta? Very expensive as well, so it doesn't really matter. You know, it doesn't really matter, and that's not one's really business, but I guess you guys wouldn't know that. So I'm a girl, I love to move, moving on up, I love that, whatever. The thing with my townhome, we moved out of there because of dogs. You cannot have dogs, and at the time Block wanted these different dogs and all of that, so end up getting rid of the dogs because he was not keeping up with the dogs, but we could live in the community with the dogs either. It was a very strict community, had a lot of home association rules, and they followed them. And if we couldn't follow them, we had to go. And that was understood. As adults, what you do, you go. Cobb County is not a place to play with, period, point blank, if you're from Georgia. So you gotta follow the rules at the end of the day. Anyway, next, what else? If Block leave me, it was said that I wouldn't be able to still pay my bills. Understand, like I said, I'm a girl that always was raised to pay my own bills and take care of myself. If he left me today, I still would be able to afford my bills because I'm a very smart young lady and I've been that way. Before him, we've been dating for 2 years. I stayed in stuff like this. I stayed in all of the best, upstairs, downstairs, lofts, all kind of stuff. And I've always had the best furniture from the best furniture stores. If they wasn't custom, if I didn't get them built myself, I bought them from By Design, Huff Furniture, all of that stuff, the well-known places in Atlanta. Y'all cannot keep comparing me to a couple that's doing their damn thing. I'm not gonna discredit them, period. I like Dear, I like Ken, I like what they stand for. They're doing their damn thing. But you're not gonna compare me because I've been doing what I'm doing. And they doing what they doing, and they doing a good job at it. They inspire me in some ways to travel more. You feel what I'm saying? To see more. You feel what I'm saying? But chandeliers and California closets, I've been had that. Just because I did not YouTube my life 4 years ago, 3 years ago, 2 years ago, or 12 months ago, don't mean I didn't have it. They did not start anything. And I don't even think they feel that way. It's subscribers and YouTube people that make drama between people and then make people have to react to it. I don't even know if they read their comments. They're well more experienced with this YouTube stuff. I've been a YouTuber for 2 months, if that. 3 times. So a lot of stuff that YouTubers know not to do, I still don't know the do's and don'ts. I'm learning as I go. No one's teaching me and I don't need no one to. So it is what it is. I'm addressing this because, hold on, stop, wait 1 minute. You know, I gotta check it. And I just gotta check it grown. I gotta check it 2017. I can't check it like 2016. I'm not gonna bitch, hoe, none of that. We're not gonna do that here. We're gonna keep it cute. You know, we're gonna get our coins. That's what we're gonna do. That's what I stand for. So anyway, as we continue to go through this, I wanna say that I'm all about building and uplifting women, and that's what I want my YouTube page to be about, my channel. I will stop. I will end this and I will sleep the same and I will be okay, because I'm not in it for the coins. I make coins, okay, that's a benefit, but that's not why I signed up for YouTube. I don't link up with people to get more coins, and I don't do none of that stuff. I don't even get it. You feel what I'm saying? I'm still not even getting YouTube. I'm still in learning. I'm still learning as I go. So that's just what it is. So understand, if my guy left me today, Posh will still be Posh. I was born Posh. I was born diamond. So I was always accustomed to what I'm nice things, and I work. My mom taught me to work hard to get nice things. Nothing will be given to me in life. And I'm sure your parents taught you the same thing. I'm sure your parents did not teach you to have a bad trait of being a big ass hater. I'm sure your parents did not teach you the trait of being a internet cyber thug. I'm sure they didn't. Can't nobody defend themselves? Can't nobody touch you through comments? So at the end of the day, we're not gonna fight, argue, or I'm not gonna get frustrated about it. I'm just gonna address it and keep it cute, get my coins, you know. So my Posh babies always defend and go back and forth with people, but for y'all, I love y'all, and I don't want y'all to feel like y'all gotta defend me ever. I don't want y'all to feel like we gotta explain ourselves to them, because at the end of the day, they click, they view, it's okay, it's a coin, we get the coin, we got it. You feel what I'm saying? So if, you know, they mad about something, they upset about something, that's kind of going to be a personal situation with them. That kind of is not going to have nothing to do with us. So at the end of the day, that's just going to be on them. That's going to be on them. What else they said? Like I said, all of that stuff I had, and it's just funny that me and Deira or Ken or whoever picks out the stuff, we have similar tastes. I always love chandeliers. I always love lights. I always had California closets. No matter what kind of place I live in, I will always build one, because it's just, I like to see my stuff and I like for it to be organized, because I really love getting up, putting on clothes and getting dressed every day. So the California closets make it better for me, because I can organize my stuff because I have so much, and it's great, you know? It's great. So tall, tufted beds and all that stuff, I've been doing that for so long. I've had so many different beds that I've designed myself or whatever over the years. But don't compare me to them and don't do any of that. You feel what I'm saying? We're all around the same age. And like I said, I moved out my mom's house at 19 by choice. My mom has a big house on the south of Atlanta, and it's just, I had 2 bedrooms in my mom's house. When the 2 men in the truck pulled up to my house to move, my mom thought I was joking. I had started buying furniture. I was like, Mom, I'm about to move. She didn't believe me. I moved. The 2 men in the truck, I mean, I did it so professionally. She couldn't do it. She cried to her friend. She was yelling at me like, don't take nothing I bought. But she was just so hurt. But she was so proud because she knew she had raised me well. Like, my mom gave me a good curfew. But I just did not respect the fact that I wanted to come in. I didn't respect the fact that coming to my mama's house past 12. And sometimes parties or hanging out with your friend or your boyfriend at the time, it went over that time. I did not, my mom raised me to always say yes ma'am, no ma'am to her. And respect was all the time high with my mom. I'm scared of my mom. So I don't know about how you is with your parents, but 23 years, I'm still scared of my mom. So anyway, that's about the only person in God. So I just got my own place because I wanted to. So yeah, went to Atlanta Station. I went downtown, was my first apartment, Century Skyline. And then from there, I went to Atlantic Station, stayed in Atlantic Station about 3 years, had different lofts in Atlantic Station. Went from there to 7712. That's another high rise, very glass full. I'm going to put pictures in this vlog, a bunch of my places, furniture. In Atlanta, I did this wall that went haywire. It went viral on the internet. Everybody started doing the wall, and now people still have the wall, even in their salons, their spas, all kind of different places have the wall that I did. I think it was about 3-4 years ago.
and it just went haywire. It was an actual stencil I ordered from a website. And if I can remember the website, I'll put it in the description box. But and the wall just went crazy. Everybody started doing it. Everybody literally started putting this wall in their house. And the guy that did it for me, he got so much business off of my promo on Instagram. He just started doing the wall everywhere in Atlanta in different states. He even went to Florida and stuff doing walls. But anyway, yeah, so that was that. I've been like nice and liking nice things. I've always been into home decor, always love home goods, all those different places. I always love all this stuff that I do now. I've been doing for a very long time, since I before my room at my mom's house was decked out. It's still decked out in pink and black and white, my name on the wall, other little cute little stuff. I always been into that type of stuff since a little girl. Yeah, so that's pretty much it. Like, one thing about me, I'll always state facts. I'm never gonna make up some stuff to make myself look more appealing or for people to like me. It is what it is, but I don't really know how to allow people to tell lies on me and not defend myself. So a lot of people DM me and they say, hey, Posh, don't address them, you know, like, you know, don't be sad about it, or don't, you know, just don't entertain, let haters be haters. But it sounds so good. I'm honestly Aquarius and we're very strong individuals, and I do feel like God, you know, built me for to be able to take all this backlash. But I'm human and sometimes my feelings get hurt too. I'm a person that shell them and keep them in the inside, but you know, I just burn up eventually when the wrong word hits. So that's pretty much what it is. But I mean, we've been talking for 13 minutes and I think I've covered it. But like, you know, whatever, you know, you're gonna say I can own my car, you're gonna say I don't own my car when I own my car, you know, it don't matter. So this will be ever be, I can't say never, because I don't want to say never, but this won't, at the moment while I'm trying to grow, I will not be explaining myself. What you see in the comments, I will delete them and I will keep it moving, and I won't even continue to read. If it start off bad, I'll just delete it, keep it moving, and you're blocked from my channel. Not, you can't watch my channel, period. Because I don't want to, the new year has started and so much drama. It's just like, like, it don't supposed to be that way. Like, that was left in the last year and I'm just not gonna have it. So with that being said, my Posh babies, I never want to punish you for other people's doing. I love you guys. You guys mean the most to me. And I'll continue doing this for you. I have subscribers that are 12 years old, 13 years old. So I'm going to watch how I talk, what I say, and how I move. Because you never know who you're teaching without knowing that you're teaching. So I'm going to use my own advice and just want to say I love you guys. So be back. Hi, babies. So you know your girl had to come with her receipts. And plus, I just wanted y'all to get to know me a little better. This was one of my condominiums. I had one of my custom walls and custom Chanel paintings. This was my place at 7712th. It was an all-glass condo. This sofa actually is from Madani, the same sofa that DK4L has in their home now. I believe this was 2015, 2016 when I stayed in this unit. Closer to 2015 when I actually purchased that sofa. I love this place. It was all glass. It was really nice. It was really fabulous. The only reason why I moved from there was because of racism issues. So yeah, that was a mess and I just didn't feel comfortable. This is the same unit, as you see, it's all glass. It was a corner unit, so it was actually all glass all over the condo. And this chair over there was from Adani as well. And I just wanted to show y'all that clearly, even though this was in 2015, we had very similar tastes because they have the sofa now. And I just don't think it should have been compared, period. But I had to come to with my receipts because I don't want anybody to feel like I'm copying anybody when clearly I'm not. So like I said, I love this place. It was really, really nice and very tasteful. This was my second loft I had in Atlantic Station. 17th Street Lofts. It was really, really nice. I've always been into decor and having really fancy stuff going on. This actual custom wall I did are now in like a lot of nail salons and hookah bars in Atlanta, and people got the idea from me. I had this in 2014, so this is my second loft in 2014, and it was really, really fabulous. I think this picture, I was just taking a picture of my shoes that I had got. And this picture is in my second loft, the same one you just seen in the last picture. This is my living room. I had a gold custom tufted couch with a hint of royal blue. This was so fabulous. I really miss this living room. This was It was really nice. I really loved it. This was my baby. This was my first loft, but my very second apartment. Before this, I stayed downtown. So this was now Midtown and Atlantic Station. This was the ATL Lofts. This was the wall that went viral on Instagram, Twitter, and Pinterest. Everybody copied this wall. To this day, it's a lot of businesses that have this wall. It always was my baby. And of course, you guys see I had a chandelier. I've always been obsessed with them. This was 2014, 2013. So you guys asked for a tour for our move. We have a bookcase. I'm already taking stuff down. Cable box, internet. Have a TV, surround system. Fireplace. Another bookcase. Then we have my first level, my porch. We have a porch. Me. I have this little console. I have to turn off the alarm. Hi guys, so I had to speed this video up just because it would have been a little too long, but as you guys see, this is just a walkthrough of the townhome I stayed in before what I stay in now. So enjoy this video. Hi guys, so I want to say thank you for enjoying my vlog, and I just wanted to show you all the places I have lived from 2014 to, I say, 2016. So the last place was my townhome, and I told you guys why, of course, earlier in the vlog, why we had to move out due to Block's dogs and his little baby. So that was that situation, but I wanted you guys to see it. My townhome was so beautiful. So now, officially, after this place I'm living in now, I am looking into purchase a new townhome or a new house. I'm so excited about that. So wish me luck. I should begin looking probably in the next month or two, because I'm just going to finish off my lease I am in now and be done with the condos and apartments and all of that shindig. So like I said, I did this, and this will be my last time explaining myself, but I feel like I had to, because at that time, all of my journeys and stuff I had been through, my moving, my decor, I was not vlogging then, so I felt like it was only right for y'all to get to know me, see where I've been living for the past years, and it's always been fabulous. Thank you guys.
Right on Concord, where you find me at? Party never ending, we insomniacs. First tap the bottle, then twist the cap. I do anything now to bring them times back, just to feel like the world is yours. Same time, shorty, you're on off.